Hello YouTube, Luke here again. Next deck profile here. This is the Rinne memory build. Last time I showed the change build. That's anyway, here we go. Level zeros. Starting off with four Roy Bellinetta. Now when this is reversed in battle, pay one, put the top card of your library into your clock, send this to memory, search a deck for Rinne, and add it to your hand. It's an important card. For Rinne Cold Eyes, the front row center slot gets 500 power to pay one brainstorm. Rest this for each climax card. Sent to the waiting room, you get to search for a melee or clothes character. For Classmate Bully, so it's has two effects when it's played from the hand to the stage. One is mill the top two cards of your library to your waiting room. If there's a climax, you have to rest this. The other one is you choose a Rinne, you put it in your clock. This goes to the memory, and then from your deck, you can put this onto the field and it gains 1500 power until the end of your opponent's turn. That's the just end anything, Rinne. Here we have four Rinne. Small happy thing, so if your opponent has three or more climaxes in the waiting room, you have to rest this, but it can run in front of other characters on your opponent's turn, so it's an oversized runner. So let's go to the level ones now. So here we have the card from before, the Just End Anything Rinne. So if you have two or more cards in memory, gains 1000 continuous, has a climax combo. When Pass That Can't Be Changed is played, you can choose Roy, Beloved Grandfather, Classmate Bully, or Scuderia. It, from the waiting room, goes into the library, and this gains 3000 power for the turn. Yeah, so it can possibly be 8500. Here is the Roy, Beloved Grandfather. Has a climax combo. So pay one, send this to memory. So once again, when the past everything can't be, sorry, when the past can't be changed, choose to just send anything Rinne that's in your waiting room. Place it on the stage, and it gains 2,000 power to the end of your opponent's turn. Also play two Jill Meeting Rinne. So if you have two or more other Rinnes on the field, it gains 2,000 power, and it has a continuous encore effect of discard a blue character. Sorry, just a blue card, actually, from your hand to the waiting room. So possible 7,500 with encore for level one, pretty good. Let me just move them forward a bit. All right, and lastly, we have two backups. This is the Super Transformation Time Rio. It's straight 1k, but when it's played, it also gives another 1000 to a character, so whether it be the one that's being attacked or 1000 to, say, a different character on your team. Okay, level 2, so 3, Rinne Seeking Strength, for the other characters, Amelia Close against 2500, and the card opposite this cannot side attack it. And also, if this is during your opponent's turn, if this reverses your opponent's character, you can draw a card. It's pretty strong. Works really well in the change build. Also have one of this, the Rinne Ring Entrance. So 2500 backup also has the effect of pay to put a character from your stage into the waiting room. When you use the backup of this, you can pay. If so, choose one of your opponent's characters whose level is higher than the current level and of your opponent, and put in the waiting room so you can get rid of advanced summons. Also play the four Scuderia. So choose one of your characters to win its name, send it to the waiting room, heal one from the top card of your clock, and send this to memory. Okay, for level threes, Parson Fitters Rinne, if there are two or fewer climax cards in your waiting room, gains minus one level in your hand. For each of your back row with either melee or close, gains 1000 power. Also, when it's placed around the stage, put the top card of your clock into your waiting room, so it's a healer as well. Pure white total fighter Rinne. So when it's so if you have two or more other melee characters against 1,000 continuous, when it's played at the end of stage, draw two, discard one. Also, when this card's attacked and I don't cancel the damage, I can pay three, deal the same amount of damage to my opponent. And also got three Renee ready in the drizzle as a climax combo with all the cards in memory. So when this is placed for the end of the stage, draw two, discard one. Climax combo, discard a card from your hand to the waiting room. When distraction or strike is paid. Choose any number of your Roy Villanetta, classmate Bully, Roy Beloved Grandfather, or Scuderia in the memory. Send them to the waiting room and deal damage to the number of cards sent this way. Alright, so the climax is... So... four pass that can't be changed. So it's a split 2k1. So obviously if you're gonna use a climax combo with this, you'll send that. So you're gonna put your 2k1s to your other two characters. And also four of the distractionless strike, it's a stock soul. So both of these are two soul when they triggers, and this one when it's placed from the here's a climax zone, choose up to one blue card in your waiting room, can it be in blue, put in your stock and all your characters gain a soul for the turn. Alright, so that's the memory build. So until next time, thank you all for watching and see you again soon.